The 108 Hanuman Chalisa became very popular. It started in 1998.
We privileged to be involved with the community that comes forward and supports us and give willingly to this. So with that, we hope that the values that Hanuman stands for is imbibed by all our community and that they express that in their daily lives.
The power of this Hanuman Chalisa 108 can be summed up in this beautiful mantra: Sankachadvam Samvadadvam Samvomanansi Janatam Deva Bhagam Yathapurve Sanjanana Upasate. That is the power.
Hello guys, welcome to my channel Roaming Devi. Today I am going to cover auspicious occasion which is called the Hanuman Jayanti, and this is celebrated here in Vishnu Mandir in Cape Town. And today the plan is from 5 a.m. morning to 8 p.m. night, 108 Hanuman Chalisa there will be recital. So lot of Hindu Parishad groups, they will be coming here and they will be chanting the slokas of Hanuman Chalisa throughout the day. So I joined very late actually, so it's already started at 5 a.m. and this festival is going on every year. I don't know the exact years which I'm going to cover when I'm going to discuss with the members of the organization. So I will give you a glimpse of how the Hanuman Chalisa, I mean slokas, are going on here. And that's what the video is all about. On Hanuman, as you know, it's very specific to Hindu religion, who is a great devotee of Lord Rama. He has a very big importance because of his special qualities. He helped Lord Rama to get his wife Sita. So I'm not going to go into the details. Any Hindu person, they must be knowing all this. So I'm just trying to show you in this video how in Cape Town, I mean in South Africa, where Hinduism is having a deep root here, and also people celebrate widely the various Hindu festivals in Cape Town. Okay, so let's go and watch this Hanuman Chalisa 108 times here in Vishnu Mandir in Cape Town.
Thank you. I'm not afraid.
Welcome to my channel, Roaming Devi. I'm very privileged that such a big, Hanuman Chalisa program is going on. This is my first time in Cape Town, which I'm doing this, vlogging for Hanuman Chalisa in 2024. So, Jawahar Bhai, you are one of the key members of this organization. So, can you give me a background of this Hanuman Chalisa, since when it is started and how things are going on till now?
So, the 108 Hanuman Chalisa became very popular. It started in 1998. And amongst the youth, as you can see, I'm wearing a youth t-shirt here. I started off as a Yuvak Sangh member. I joined the Hindu Association of the Western Cape. And this event has grown phenomenally. And it has become an annual calendar event. And at the moment, we are celebrating the 108 Hanuman Chalisa at the Samaj. And we have in the Sanyasa Council of South Africa joining us in this Chalisa. Thank you.
That's great. Thank you very much. Madam, welcome to my channel. Madam, what's your, I have been seeing you in many programs throughout my stay in Cape Town. So I'm privileged that you are organizing such a fabulous, festival for Hindu. So can you tell me something about Hanuman Chalisa of 2024?
Well, I think, like Jawahir says, this year is a special year because we have the members of the Sanyasa Spiritual Council with us, the Swamijis. We're privileged to have them here. But I think from Hindu Association of the Western Cape, the fact that we're the umbrella body for all the organization, and this is one of the key events since 1990 that have brought people together across organizations, linguistic groups, etc. And it, besides people that belong to the particular organization, it involves the whole of the Western Cape community. So we privilege to be involved with the community that comes forward and supports us and gives willingly to this. So with that, we hope that the values that Hanuman stands for is imbibed by all our community and that they express that in their daily lives.
Thank you, Jawaharbhai. Thank you again, madam. You have given a good insight. So, to all my viewers who are Hindu, actually followers of Hindu, they don't feel alien in South Africa because it has a very deep connection with Hinduism. And you can see the example of this from so many years. They are doing this Hanuman Chalisa. And really, I really felt I'm in India, actually. This kind of things regularly happen in every community of India. I'm very thankful and I'm blessed that I'm part of this organization and also watching this and getting blessed for Hanuman Chalisa.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to take some valuable information from various saints who has arrived in this program. So one of them is Swami Vedanand ji. Swami ji, namaste. Welcome to my channel.
Namaste. Jai Shri Ram. All I can say, the power of today, the power of this Hanuman Chalisa 108 can be summed up in this beautiful mantra. Sankachadvam, Sambadadvam, Sambomanansi Janatam, Deva Bhagam Yathapurve, Sanjanana Upasate. That is the power that we get today. The unity of all our Hindus singing the name of Sri Hanuman, the great Bhakta of Sri Ram.
Thank you Guruji. Thank you very much. I'm privileged.
Thank you.
I'm going to introduce Swami Guru Bhaktanam. Guru Bhaktanamji, namaste. And I'm going to get your valuable advice to the world as a peace. And also this Hanuman Chalisa is obviously a very big thing. So I wanted to take a few words from you.
All the devotees of Cape Town are assembled here in the surgery of Dr. Hanuman. And when they finish 108 Hanuman Chalisas, Hanumanji will give them a big injection of devotion that will last for a whole year, and we'll come back and assemble again and sing his name next year also the same way. Thank you.
Namaste. Thank you very much. Now I have another respected son, Chaitanyandaji. So Chaitanyaji, namaste. From all Hindu devotees who are watching my channel, so Chaitanyaji, I am privileged that you are part of my channel. Although my channel is on various topics, such as this first time I am covering a very religious thing. Obviously people really love how Hinduism is so strong in South Africa. I wanted to hear some words from you.
Hari Om devotees and other people. It was a great pleasure for me to be here. What I have noticed is the vibrations are very, very powerful. Being devotional vibrations, it has the power to get into the mind and clean all the bad things from the mind. It will elevate people to a higher level of existence. Let it happen as often as possible, and let us make sure that all the people are getting transformed, and so that we will have a new, more peaceful and happy society. Thank you so very much.
Thank you, Guruji. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Oh. निरंतर हनुमदवीरा संकट से हनुमान दुरारे भद्रनि कंकन राम दुलारे आदसी नवनिधि के राजा
Thank you. It's an important time of our lives as Bharat is having the elections, is going on by stages, and South Africa is going to have the elections at the end of May. And today, let me pray with the richest blessings of Bhagwan, may the Ram Rajya become effective in Bharat. And may also continues here, because whatever happens in India, South Africa follows. May that also happen right here, and global peace. Jai Sri Ram!
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 In this present age where we are living, also there is an immense fear in the people's mind, particularly the lives of women and children. And today, let me pray, the Hanuman Ji brings a protective shield around you. May you feel freely move around wherever you want to, and may you all protect it. Jai Sri Ram!
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 Now we're going to do the final arati. The arati will be done in two stages. The first one is where we're going to complete the procedure what we started out this morning. And thereafter, that we're going to do the Mangala arati, that you are going to be participating in that. And also, we would like to bring Sri Gurudeva be part of this 108 recital. So he's going to do the Hanuman Sloka and the concluding sloka for the arati. And then Shivaram will now take the water from the kalsa, will sprinkle each and every one of you. Make sure you will get one drop, like the rain drop on you. So make sure that you are blessed today before you leave. And then thereafter, we will do the arati, and the formalities will be now introduced by Sri Javahir Bhai. So I go to Sri Gurudeva.
Yidendriyam Purthimadam Parishtam Vadatmajam Vanarajimukamukhyam Siramagurvam Shirasamam Ullanyi Sintu Paridam Sariyam काञ्चनेयमतिबाढदानम् काञ्चनात्रि नमनीय विग्रहम् पालिकालकर्मूलवाशिनम् पावयामि भवमाननन्दनम्
कामेश्वरो वै श्रवणो ददातु कुबेराय वै श्रवणाय महाराजाय नमः श्री हनुमान चालीसा स्तोत्र पारायण नमः पुण्यदर्भाय सीता लक्ष्मण भरत चतुर्घ्न हनुमत समेत श्री रामचंद्र मूर्ति परिपूर्ण बालराजित्यम आंजनेय स्वामी परिपूर्ण बालराजित्यम धर्मार्थ काम मोक्ष सदुर्विद परमपुरुषार्थ सत्यम सकल व्याधि निवारणार्थम अष्ट ऐश्वर्यानां अभिमित्यम आंजनेय स्वामिने नमो कावेरी नमस्तुभ्यं नमो नमः सर्वेभ्यो देवेभ्यो नमो नमः
yesterday, and they need 3,000 rand to
sponsor each child, and from hope we will be sponsoring one child. And we want to appeal to all of you who can do something, even if you can't sponsor one child. Every 10 rand, 20 rand together would make up to 3,000 rand to sponsor a child. So please, I think all of you know the Children of Light School. If you don't, I think Priya is here. You can speak to Priya after we finish. And we'd really like to appeal to you to sponsor them and support this very good cause. For those of you who don't know, the children that are being supported come from really, really sad backgrounds. And the Children of Light School not only supports the children with their financial needs for their education, etc., but I think the spiritual knowledge that they give those children, the support they give to the parents to make sure that those children children's lives are enriched. Who is the head of the Sannyasa Council, the coordinator of the Sannyasa Council, and also the head of the RSMR South Africa. And then we have with us Swami Chaityanandaji, who is from the Integral Yoga Center in Pietermaritzburg. Swami Guru Bhaktananda, who you all know as Krishna, well known to us here in the Cape Town. And then we had Swami Ram Kripanandaji with us until yesterday. Swami is visiting to see what they can do to support our organizations, make them stronger, better, promote Hindu pride amongst individuals, and promote unity within our communities so that that filters to the broader community. Having said that, I would like to invite Swami Vedanandaji to address you for a few minutes.
Bhavana Putra Hanuman Ki! Bhavana Putra Hanuman Ki!
I see. When Sri Hanuman plucked his hair to prove his devotion to Sri Ram, what was heard in that follicle of hair? Ram, 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 Ram. And that wherever Sri Ram resides, there shall I be. This morning, at the stroke of 5, we invoked Agni to begin our vrat, to chant that Hanuman Chalisa of that ideal supreme devotee of Sri Ram 108 times. To invoke the courage, the strength, the pride, and the fearlessness of the ideal devotee, Hanuman. Just as these gale force winds hit this mother city, so too does that might of Sri Hanuman strike us now. That as we closed within every hair follicle of yours, within every cell of yours, that vibrates with the name Sri Ram, who lies there within? Hanuman. All I can say, go out there with courage, with fearlessness, with compassion, with dedication and commitment, and be the bhakta to that divine Sri Ram as Hanuman echoes through every cell of your body. For today, you have invigorated yourself. Today, we have invigorated each other. We have proven the end of that Rig Veda, Sankachadvam, Samvadadvam, Samvomanansi Janatam, Deva Bhagam Yata Purve, Sanjanana Upasate, that there is might in unity, that there is devotion in unity, and that there is success in unity.
I'm Manner with a plan, but anyway, still I'm thankful that lot of respected saints part of this program. A beautiful program happened, and you know the recitation of Hanuman Chalisa starting from 5 a.m. till 8 p.m. in the night,
yes, yeah.
Non-stop. Can you imagine? It is non-stop, 104 times non-stop. It's 108 times from 5 a.m. till 8 p.m. non-stop, including for devotees. There is a lunch. And as you heard, Jawahar Bhai, Gagan Madam, and all the sites, you can see how beautifully they have organized.
And Amit Bhai also.
And Amit Bhai also. So there are a lot of people actually, I will recollect. Thank you very much for watching my channel. It's altogether a different video, but anyway, those who are Hindu people in South Africa or in Cape Town, you have beautiful temples
worldwide.
You can give a thumbs up whenever you come to Cape Town. Come to
Vishnu Temple.
This is Vishnu Temple.
Cape Town,
where you can come and offer your prayer. And you can, even you can be part of their various cultural programs which happen throughout the year. Okay. Thank you, Rakesh Bhai.
Thank you, Devi. Jai Shri Ram, Jai Hanuman.
Jawahar Bhai, can you come, please?
This is
Jawahar Bhai. Our Jawahar Bhai, who is the main, I mean, organizer actually of this program, and he is a very prominent figure in Hindu, in Cape Town, in terms of Hindu community actually.
Yes.
Most of the programs, he is the key person. So if you have really wanted to do something in Hindu related, I mean Hinduism related, cultural program, something, see this person, Mr. Jawahar, you can connect him, he is going to give you the roadmap.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.